Okay, so I wanted to share this one with you, which is pretty amazing. Now, this is a sculpt I made in ZBrush, but I brought it into Medium and cleaned it up and done some of the important and have done some of the important areas like the claws and the teeth and things like that, and the paint work, and just tidied up the the overall feel and the texture of the creature. It's very battle cat looking, but I just I can't explain how amazing this is to be able to bring a sculpt in from ZBrush in so accurately as a representation. This was just a DynaMesh sculpt. With a bit of processing, like surface processing, some little hidden techniques I like to use. And I mean, this is just alpha brushes here, and this is just a layer after I sculpted the spine. I increased the layer and it's drawn, skewed up the spikes. But my what I'm finding is it's just unbelievable the amount of form language and how much control you have in Medium over these designs. It's just unbelievable. You almost it's almost in such a way where ZBrush just is so clunky in moving these surfaces and allowing you to access these proportions, and I think it's so it's one of those another moment in Medium where you go, like what the F, how did this even come about? I mean, even the paint, like the paint work is so fun to do. Like everything here was fun. The rocks were fun, and probably one thing I'll show you that is just a quick one. You probably know this stuff, but you pick your brush, you put your opacity around, a moderate size and a moderate opacity, and you pick a color that's like a dirty brown, and back coloring is really cool. Like you can, I'll just increase it so you can see. You can back color things, so I can increase the occlusion, but I can also like back color this stuff. So it's like blackwashing in airbrush with airbrushing, but it allows you to. It's just amazing. Like it's so cool. Like you can do it with all types of surfaces. You're not restricted just to one sort of surface. And yeah, it's like. And it just occludes the detail, and you pull in there and occlude the detail and get the detail running how you want it. And just pick all the little spots out you think that might need to have occluded darkness and black wash it in such a way. Yeah. So just a quick one. I wanted to sort of record this through Twitch and then post it up onto the Facebook page on the Medium Facebook page. But my next step is to just quickly cut him up. I mean, it'd be pretty raw, but cut him up and turn his head and I mean, you can do that stuff now, like pretty crazy in a radius. Yeah, about that, I suppose. Kind of pick a fall off that's like holding the heavy, like the heavy form, and then the fall off would be the stretch form. That's how I sort of look at it. So turn mirror off, and I'll save this and just do a quick test just to show how easy it is to pose up a creature's posture or look, I mean, it's basically just like that, you know. And you get all the creasing, you get all the beauty of the crease and stuff. So, like that, there's nothing wrong with that. Like, that's just amazing. Like, just wild. Like, that's so cool. So yeah, thanks for having a look, and yeah, it's just so fun. I mean, you know, yeah, what I would do is I would duplicate this whole creature and put him on another layer and just hide it and then start to cut it up. And I tend to use a mirrored version to cut from and then save the mirrored version like as a base sculpt and then pose a duplicate. So yeah, there you go. Oh, it's just wild. Look at that. Just amazing. Wow. Just amazing. I don't really... Oh, I'm going to have to duplicate it. So anyway, thanks guys. Thanks for having a quick look. And I'll cut it off now. So...